So let me take you back into what we were talking about last time. We were talking about the iterated prisoner's dilemma, and here's the prisoner's dilemma payoffs that you wrote down for us. Do you remember this?
I vaguely remember this.
And remember, it was about these two criminals, Smoove and Curly, and they were deciding whether to cooperate or defect against each other after they've been arrested.
Right, and they defect. They always defect.
They always defect, right. So in particular, we said, well, what happens if they have multiple rounds in which to interact? And so here they are, here are the two of them, and if they got one round to live, we did an analysis and we indicated that there's really nothing they can do other than defect against each other. It just is irrational to do anything else.
Yep.
So we said, all right, well, what happens if we allow there to be more than one round? So now we've got two rounds, and what we realized was that if you've got two rounds to go, then these players essentially face a one-round game, because after this round, what they're going to do in the last round has already been determined. So it's almost as if that round doesn't really matter. There's nothing we can do now that's going to change what they're going to do in that last round. So it's sort of like there's just one round and we're going to defect again.
Right. So life is terrible and everyone is out to get everyone else.
Exactly. And not only is it for two rounds, but this same argument continues as you go three rounds or more.
Oh, it's like a proof by induction.
It's kind of like a proof by induction. Yeah. Well, it's proof by ellipsis.
That's my favorite kind of induction. Proof by ellipsis.
So the question then becomes, what happens if the number of rounds left is unknown, right? So what we realize is that if you know how many rounds are left, the whole thing comes unraveled and they're just going to defect forever. But we raise the issue of what happens if the number of rounds left is unknown. And it seems like it shouldn't really make any difference, because if it's, say, some finite number, we just don't know what it is, then it seems like it should just still reduce to the same setup that we have. So I was looking into this, and it turns out that is it's not the case. It actually does make a difference, and it's really interesting how it goes and how it connects back with other things we've talked about.
Ooh, tell me more.